What is good, Greg Gang? We're here today. We're going to be doing some bass fishing in a pond. There is snow on the ground, but that's not going to stop us, okay? But before we go fishing, I think I got a stinking deal at Walmart. I went to the clearance section, and I about cleared them out of their clearance stuff. But anyways, let me show you what I got. Because, guys, I bought a lot of it. Here we go. First thing I pull out, boom, some stinking power bait chigger crawls in black and blue. 75 cents. Are you crazy? How could I not have bought those? Next thing, a pack of robo worms. $1? Are you kidding? For $1? Next up in the lineup, we got these right here. Perfect plastics. Were they swimming caffeine shads for $1? Like, bro, I'd be losing money if I didn't buy those. Next up right here, I got some cricket hooks, long chain cricket hooks. Bro, 25 cents. That's not even a dime. I mean, it is, but it's a quarter. But for real, guys, I saved $1.16. That is crazy. And then right here, I bought these things. I don't even know what they are, but they were 10 cents, so I bought them anyway. And then last, but definitely cost the least, 10 cent walleye and trout hooks. Now, do I fish for walleye or trout? No, but they're 10 cents, and I bought them anyway. Needless to say, guys, I'm pretty pumped about the hour I spent in Walmart. It was lit, guys. Like I know lit is sort of going out of style, but that was truly lit. Fire emoji, fire emoji. And you know, one of the funniest parts is I was looking at all the clearance stuff. I saw some braided line. So I was like, whoa, that's braided line. How much is it? $18 on clearance. I was like, what? I went over there to the regular ply stuff and it was only $16. Like Walmart, you're giving me some cheap deals, but that doesn't make sense. Like for real, thanks for all this stuff that I got a good deal on, but that doesn't even make sense, guys. But anyways, guys, enough of my rant. Let's go bass fishing, and at the pond we're going to, it's got a monster. And here's proof. Here's last year. Little clip of it. Oh, there's a good one. Oh my gosh. That's a good one too. Bro, I got a giant. Oh my gosh. Hurry, Shelby, get over here. This is the good one. Oh my gosh. This is a good one. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! That was a 7-pounder!
The good one!
You gotta be kidding me. That was my PB. Oh my gosh.
I'm telling you guys, it was at least 8 pounds of not even line. Okay, boys, we're at the pond. It is flooded. Usually you can walk to about, I don't know, 5 feet past the, like, what you can see right there. I'm starting out with a little jerkbait. What are you starting out with, Shelby? Little crankbait looking outfit. But the pond is flooded.
That tree? Was it here last time? The beavers are done eating on it.
Yeah, that's what happened. That's why it's knocked down.
That's why it is knocked down. There's a fish. Pretty good one. Decent one. Not a macho, but a bass. On the jerkbait. And he's very hyper. Maybe he's excited that he's going to be on YouTube. Not a gigantor. Not the 7-pounder we're after. But he's about 7 inches, and that's about the same thing in my book. There you go, bass. Yeah, close enough. I mean, hey. What?
Yeah. It says it on the box, but like I didn't pay a bit of attention to you. I thought it'd tell me on
the Uh-oh.
Board.
I may have one. I do. There is one. Tell you what. Oh, I was about to say he was a big one. I would have been wrong. He's just acting big. I don't know what's wrong with these fish, bro. Like, they're so hyper. I mean, I guess that's fine with me. Call him a little wacky rigged exo stick right there. Ain't no. Got bit by that little feller. Still after the 18 pounders, but you know, they may come here later in the day.
Okay, guys, right now it's a little bit change of scenery here. We're at the lake. As we were putting in, yeah, I'm here with him. As we were putting in, there's another tournament going on, and they had some pretty big bags. I ain't gonna lie. And I'm also not gonna lie about this. I definitely peeked over in their boat and saw if they were using little shad rig. Or at least that's one of the baits I saw. I don't know if they were catching them on that, but that's what I saw. Along with the A-rig and another crankbait. The water temperature is 49.3 degrees. It's actually got colder from the last time I've been here.
Here we go, boys. Got a little red wiggle board on. Oh, we're just gonna see what happens. Throw down some rocks. He's throwing an A-rig. We're just gonna see what they want. If they don't want anything moving, I got a shaky head on. That will be our second option. But anyways, here we go. There's a fish. Trout, though. Fish, but a trout. No bass. He thought, I guess. He thought he was something. I did too.
Oh my gosh!
Bro, okay, so I'm sitting here, you know. Okay, so here's what happened. We went to the lake. I'm sorry, guys. I'm not exactly the best fisherman in the world. I only caught one trout. So what's my excuse? I don't know. I'm going to blame it on the moon phases. But as I was sitting over here, one of these chicks actually jumped out like a, what do you call it, roosted right here, and then jumped back in. These suckers are growing. Oh, there she goes. This in here, she just jumped out, or he just jumped out. I don't know. Like I said, guys, whenever I first caught them, I don't know what they are yet. But it's getting about that time, guys. They're being able to jump. They're starting to try to flap their wings a little bit. They're getting older, guys. They're getting older. But don't worry. After they do get big enough to, like, consistently jump out, then I do have an upgrade of this. They're no longer going to be in the swimming pool. They are going to be in their own cage. And, you know, it's a pretty nice cage, too. But, nevertheless, we do have a few more days that they can stay in the swimming pool right here. So... oh, see? Yeah, look, see? They're, like, trying to fly. But, yeah, guys, these chicks over here, they are growing. I'm sorry, guys. This video's, like, you know, really short. As y'all can see, up here is blurry. We are having technical difficulties today, you know, not exactly, you know, as you can see, there's, like, a big blurry thing right here. But, unfortunately, because of that, we're not going to be able to do the favorite squad. This video's going to have to end a little bit quick. But, anyways, guys, I'm sorry about this. Be watching your feeds, people, because the next video may be earlier than Thursday, if you know what I mean. All right, see you, guys.